college football can tell both locker rooms, as we had this morning, you control your destiny to get to the championship game in the ACC, and both these programs do.
Here's Devon Edwards, as Duke will start with the football, and Edwards will start with a pretty good return out to about the 24-yard line. North Carolina won the toss and deferred their option. It was salt in the wound, too, to realize that the entire officiating staff of that game was suspended as Shaq Powell starts the game. Well, it's a huge start for Thomas Cirque as his team is set up second down and three, and here is his first throw of the game. And that goes right through the hands. Now a check by the Carolina defense as well. Now only a four-man front, and they will rush only four. Cirque has a first down. Boy, he...
And you're exactly right. One spot, put it on his belly. You make the catch for the receiver by putting it right on him.
A little read option right up the middle on the dive by Powell.
CC, but they will plug along with that inside run.
Again, a four-man rush. Again, same route. Slant underneath and a modest gain to the 45-yard line to Braxton Deaver. Elusive offensive teams on either side.
Nope.
Empty backfield for Cirque on third and three.
QB run.
Instead, it's up the seam, and that may have been tipped.
Football giving up just 152 through the air on the season per game.
So Will Monday will try and change field position, and he will do just that at the 11-yard line. A fair catch for Ryan Switzer. So and they'll start with a flea flicker. They want the big play, and Switzer all alone at midfield. A trick play for the Heels. And it's a touchdown.
Watching tape yesterday, Bob, and you said to me, as active as these safeties are, do they get a little nosy sometimes? Well, they do, and that time it's DeAndre Singleton, fourth leading tackler on this crew, but they have to get tackling out of their secondary. They do it as well as anybody in college football, but that does leave you susceptible to a big play, and what a call from Seth Luttrell, offensive coordinator, to be aggressive right from the onset.
Most touchdowns responsible for at 79, the fourth longest passing play in Carolina history. Gives them not only a 7-0 lead, but now a touchback. First carry for Jalay Duncan. Bounces it outside, breaks a tackle. Good run by Duncan. He had to avoid
it. Now to get lots of touches.
And he and Shaq Powell are expected to share the featured back role today for this Duke team. And a little option pitch to the edge. One-on-one in the open field, Jalay Duncan.
They're going to be in the right position.
Duncan again. Hammers his way for a yard. Jalay Duncan from Charlotte. And he's the lone setback on third and two. He'll try and pick it up. And he will move the chains.
And there's the in for rushing attempt.
Play action for Cirque. Wants the home run down the sideline and drops it in perfectly to Anthony Nash. And just
none, and Cirque takes advantage.
Quarterback run. Cirque spins to the 11-yard line.
Rusher for Duke.
Little toss to the edge. Jalay Duncan cuts it back. First and goal. Quarterback run again, and Cirque is brought down at the four. I thought that was a very interesting point.
Get inside 13 where it condenses, so does the passing game.
Ninth play of the drive. On the run, it's Cirque, knocked away. Empty backfield. All day for Cirque, a bullet that's almost intercepted. Had it been available, here's Ross Martin. A chip shot from 22 yards away that gets Duke on the board. But Gene Chizik called it. This game will come down to the flea flicker. Duke answered with a field goal drive that stalled at the four. TJ Logan will take a knee in our first opportunity to check in with 79. And his next touchdown will break Darian Durant's record. A little more conservative as they start this drive with Elijah Hood muscling his way.
Especially that right guard, Landon Turner.
Play action over the middle. It's a hookup with Quinch.
They're all on the same page.
Those safeties have a tendency to get up near the line of scrimmage and get nosy. And one of them here is Jeremy Cash, involved on the stop of Marquise.
Incredibly productive. 15 and a half tackles for loss out of their nickel linebacker. Amazing.
Williams, wheel route down the sideline, wide open, TJ Logan. He's got a step to the 10, and he's brought down at about the 5-yard line. Devon Edwards saved the touchdown. First and goal, Carolina at the 4.
Well, defensive coordinator Jim Knowles was a little upset on that opening play of miscommunication. He's going to be again. It's corner and it's safety, and this is a concept Carolina runs a lot. And two guys cover one. They leave the back open out of the backfield. Lots of miscommunication for a very veteran secondary right now.
Play action. Into the end zone, tipped. Trying to gather it in was Bug Howard. Keep your eyes on number 3 in motion. There goes Ryan Switzer. Instead, quarterback run and a walk-in for Marquise Williams. Another touchdown for North Carolina. And he now breaks the record. All-time 80 touchdowns responsible for in his career with the Heels.
And guess who they run behind? Get that movement, man. Run right behind your big fellas. The right guard, Landon Turner, 330, delivers a knockout punch for Marquise to run behind.
Talking about guys that are going to go to the NFL, put Landon Turner on that list. Preseason first team All-American, making his 37th career start today. And he is on the radar screen of many an NFL scout.
Now being aggressive, playing much faster, and obviously with 2 touchdowns and 2 drives very effectively in this rivalry game.
A touchback out to the 25 for Duke as Devon Edwards. As a result, it's an 11-point early lead. Empty backfield for Thomas Cirque to start this drive. He's got a hookup, and spinning is Jonnell Barnes.
Virgin, once again, that quick inside hitter effective.
Quarterback keeper. Cirque breaks a tackle. Close to another first down.
Play it. There will be opportunities for him to run.
This time on second down and 1. They play it conservatively with Joseph.
For their touchdowns when it matters the most.
Cirque once again finds Jonnell Barnes. Screen out on the edge. Caught by Barnes. He's been the workhorse. He's got a first down. Play action again for Thomas Cirque. And there a miscommunication.
Rushing 4 until they have to bring the heat.
And it was a first down without measurement. Cirque with a pump fake. Throws this into double coverage up the sideline looking for Max.
Defensive coordinator, make it difficult. Tight windows for quarterbacks to throw into.
Ajibi loses the football. North Carolina gets the takeaway. Jeff Schottmer comes up with the recovery. And it looked like Malik Simmons knocked it out. Disaster for Duke.
And Ajibi is playing today because of the injury to Sean Wilson. This is just his 3rd carry of the season. Fundamentals. Put your helmet right on the ball. That's what you're taught. It's what these guys get ingrained in training camp in what was a very physical camp. Excellent play there from both Schottmer and Simmons. 2 seniors that were a part of a disastrous defense a year ago that have really helped turn it this season.
Well, now it's on Devon Edwards, Jeremy Cash, and that Duke defense to get the football back. Marquise Williams under pressure extends the play and does a good job to throw it away. Marquise Williams identifies him and throws it right behind him. Switzer again, this time for about 2.
Scrimmage. We just have to minimize the damage done by the explosiveness of Carolina, and they haven't in this first quarter.
Romar Morris.
Get in it.
Well, they're packed in here to try and get a stop on third down, and it doesn't look like they can do it. Elijah Hood.
For North Carolina, taking advantage of some over-aggressiveness on the very first snap of the game with a flea flicker, and then coming right back.
Start, number 68, 5-yard penalty, first down.
Crowley, the center, they caught you. So first and 15. Long throw to the sideline, incomplete.
Sweeps loss.
Play action again for Williams. Floats it to the sideline, drops it in perfectly. Another big play.
Felt like because this team ran for 315 on us a year ago, they were going to run it, and they've come out throwing.
Play action again. Williams trying to extend the play, and this time he throws it away as the cover
there of those 2 defenders. Let me take advantage by getting you a little too nosy.
Breaking a tackle of Switzer. hurdles his way inside the 10. Duke defensively on their heels. A keeper for Marquise Williams. Takes a shot at about the 4-yard.
First frame would be devastating. And they do.
Another touchdown. Elijah Hood makes it 3 scores in 3 possessions for North Carolina.
And that time it wasn't Landon Turner, but it was on the other side. It was Bentley Spain. My eyes watching the movement. And we've watched the movement up and down the field in the first 15 minutes offensively. A lot of it through the air, but when they need it on the ground, back-to-back touchdown runs in the red zone. Turner and crew and Heck on the first one. And that time it was all about the sophomore Spain just washing down the entire left side of that Duke D-line.
Defensively, Duke allows 16 points per
involved. And you could see the wonderful block there by Bentley Spain, that left tackle, that sophomore. Gosh, what are we in for after the brutality emotionally of their loss to Miami 7 days ago in Williams? But number one, the number one, Deshaun Watson.
Cirque high to the sideline, probably more so than we expected in Gainesville. And off to Powell. Shaq Powell breaking tackles. Out of bounds.
Powell, Duncan, this crew to run the ball.
Another handoff and grinding out about 5 yards is Shaquille Powell. In June, he was there when he passed away, and here he is brought down for a loss of a couple. Down to 2 seconds to go. They get the snap off. Cirque, long throw, incomplete. Scoreboard for a Blue Devil fan, 21-3, North Carolina's got the lead. And we start the second quarter with the heels about to get the football back. One hop into the end zone on the Williams under pressure. Tries to avoid a sack and somehow muscles it to the sideline to throw it. TJ Logan down the sideline. That's another first.
12 yards per play, third. Behind just Baylor and TCU. Incredibly efficient.
And they grind out about 5. And they have shell-shocked Duke here early. Another carry. This time, Logan only picks up a couple. Swing pass into the flat, and that one's red. Return was a punt that North Carolina blocked against Pitt. That doesn't necessarily mean good things. And this, once again, will not be a returnable kick, because oftentimes with a flag down, their punters kick the ball so a long officials conference.
A illegal block in the back by the kicking team, number 13.
Put a drive together early here in the second quarter. And they'll start with a little read option on the ground. Shaq Powell picks up a first down. Jalay Duncan finds a crease and gets loose. Jalay Duncan inside the 10-yard line. He'll take it the distance. Exactly what Duke had to have.
And Gene Chizik doesn't like it, but that's exactly what the doctor ordered if you are Duke. Get back to basics. If Jeremy Cash is the leader defensively, it's Matt Skura. He is the bedrock foundation of this program, according to everybody you talk to. And Matt Skura there is buddy Lucas Patrick next to him. A wonderful combo block. Get to the second level. Donnie Miles, for one of the rare occasions, the leading tackler. He whiffs. And the guy that eats his cereal, Matt, turned it around momentum-wise in this building.
Well, Scotty Montgomery told us that Jalay Duncan finishes runs as well as anyone on his team. Duke right back in the game. Down by 11, thanks to their ground attack against a Carolina defense that does not give up plays like this very often. The crew, you're that kind of guy. This kick will sail all the way down into the end zone, so it's a touchback for North Carolina after we check. And they'll start with quarterback run and Marquise Williams breaking a tackle in the backfield and picking up 4.
Down to Switzer that he fended off a face mask penalty. He's a physical kid.
Throws across his body here into traffic. Handoff to the edge to Romar Morris.
Plus gains. Wonderful composure.
And well protected here. Down the sideline. Holding onto the football again is Bug Howard. He takes another shot and comes up with a catch as Devon Edwards leveled him. Right. Great concentration again.
And once again, look at the over-aggressiveness of that Duke secondary. They are just flying. You see the swing route in front. Safety is late. Has to have some awareness there if you're Singleton. Get your head around. You have a chance to make a play on the ball right now. This secondary on their heels.
Again, a play-action fake for Williams. Trying to buy some time, and this time he will throw it away.
Their defense, the dominant offense can do.
A toss to Elijah Hood. Stiff arm. Tripped up at the 31. TJ Logan and Romar Morris lining up on either side of Williams. Straight back to throw. Wants the deep ball again. This time he missed. Is from 47 on a wet field. Hits the upright. No good. Flag down. Was Duke in the...
Offsides on the defense. The 5-yard penalty will be just short of the line to gain. It'll be fourth and short.
Landon Turner, 340 is.
They try to go quickly. And they pick it up. Hustled up to the line. Swing pass. Caught in the flat by Hood. Makes a man miss on the hurdle to the 20-yard line.
Perfectly aggressive plan. He's gotten after the secondary here at Duke.
Quarterback draw. There goes Williams. Breaking tackles. He is tough to bring down.
You got a 225-pound bruising quarterback. That's a tough combo to deal with.
Looking for a jump ball in the end zone. Incomplete. Illini. The penalty on this drive, the force and effect of a turnover. And right up the middle goes Elijah Hood. Down to the goal line. Carolina thinks it's a touchdown. The officials say no. They have gotten in. Will replay buzz down? Will they need to? They do not. And Duke gets a stop. Carolina might have benefited for... They'll go quickly again. Fourth and goal. Another handoff. Does Duke get the stop? It looks like a goal line stand for the Blue Devils. Dwayne Norman was the first Duke player there. Helped out by the true freshman, Ben Humphreys. Lines up in the gun in his own end zone after the goal line stand by the Duke defense. And they'll start with Jalay Duncan. Just trying to get a little bit of breathing room and a yard to the 2-yard line. They run it again. Fighting his way to the 4-yard. Third and 7. Cirque again from the end zone. This time to throw. Well protected. Unloads down the sideline. Off the fingertips of John L. Barnes to Ryan Switzer, who has 6 career kick return touchdowns. And he's going to wave his buddies away from this one, and it's going to take a Carolina hop. And that is not... Well, now it's back on the Duke defense again. Great field position for North Carolina. Going to work and finding his man, Mack Hollins, is Marquise Williams.
Wonderful anticipation on that first down pass.
Swing pass thrown behind Romar Morris, but did a good job. Check that. Switzer in motion. They swing it to him in the flat. Stutter steps to the sideline and steps out of bounds.
That's a really good play from Jeremy Cash. It won't really show.
To the locker room. His teammates have forced 3rd down and 3. This time they'll bring a blitz. Jump ball in the end zone. Through the back of the end zone. Great one-handed catch made by Bug Howard.
Pretty.
Trying to keep it a 2-possession game. And this time Weiler is good. 15th made field goal this season for the semifinalist for the Groza Award. And it's a 2-touchdown North Carolina lead here in Chapel Hill. These hedges are perfectly trimmed, and we figured out how. And just walk Ramsey's down the sideline. He takes care of it. Donnell Barnes on 25-yard line. Cirque with a handoff, Shaq Powell with a stiff arm, and a first down.
During the run, holding by the offense, 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul, first down.
Duke gets the goal line stand, a great job by their defense in that sense. And now the run game picks them up a first down, and then Brock. Again, it's a handoff to Powell. This time, not as much, although he muscles to midfield.
Team at the line of scrimmage, and who is going to win? Who's going to win their one-on-one battles in that run-blocking game?
Cirque has missed his last six passing opportunity. Here comes a blitz. Cirque, long throw to the sideline. He needs Max McCaffrey to come up with yards after the...
Defensively, trusting Miles to win the one-on-one open field tackle, and he delivers.
Wobbly kick from Monday. And he kills it inside the 10-yard line. I want to use them to try and get their offense the ball back if they can get a stop. Swing pass to Switzer. Tracked to the sideline by Philip Carter.
For the big boy quarterback.
Second down and seven. Marquise Williams, well protected. Long throw to the sideline, trying to drop it into Switzer. And a flag down.
Such as that.
Pass interference, number 37. 15-yard penalty. Automatic first down.
And a big first down out to the 26-yard line for Carolina. Play action for Williams. He wants the bomb again. It's there! On time! Mac Collins! Touchdown!
What a tremendous half of football for Seth Luttrell. Larry Fedora and his offensive team, they have had just the feeling and the philosophy that we will not step off the gas pedal. Mac Collins is a big playmaker. Now 15 touchdown receptions, and this isn't very fancy. This isn't some rub route. This is a one-on-one against a true freshman, and Mac Collins, the fastest player on this offense, just simply runs right by the freshman McDuffie.
That's a former walk-on, Mac Collins from Rockville, Maryland. He spent every day as a freshman back in 2012 on the jugs gun, catching about 100 balls a day. And for a walk-on, it paid off as he got a clean release past McDuffie off the line.
Well, if you've got great speed, you've got to do two things. You've got to win off the ball, as you saw there, and McDuffie falling off this year. But here's a chance to beat a 6-2 team in the Duke Blue Devils. And if they do it this way and they continue with this kind of dominance, then this could
be it.
Got to respond, Thomas Cirque.
And Carolina starts the third quarter with the ball. Screen out on the edge. Picks up the ball to start the third quarter. Cirque over the middle. That's a first down hookup. Max McCaffrey. But they have struggled on the road here, down by three touchdowns. At midfield, though, with time. Cirque, high throw and a miscommunication.
That loss, and he walked through every detail and every player. And as a competitor, you never do forget those moments.
Hand-to-hand combat, an obvious pass
interference. Pass interference, number 11. Ball will be placed at the spot of the foul. Automatic first down.
Again, you impede that receiver's route, you're going to draw the penalty.
Almost intercepted after the 14-yard penalty. Four-man rush. Cirque has time, and this time he does throw an interception. Dominique Green has the pick. And Duke will come away empty once again.
And we have seen a bunch of these. He's not paid for them with the overthrows. They've fallen incomplete, but eventually, and I love, watch it. You can see the press man coverage. You see a tight NFL-esque window. It's what John Papuchis brought from Nebraska. Gene Chizik didn't know John Papuchis, but he interviewed him and said, I need this guy on my staff. What he and Bo Pelini did, this is their ball. This is why every year in Nebraska, they play great defense, perennially top 25 defense. And Gene said, say it. Say it tomorrow. John Papuchis is a star in college football. Former D coordinator, now linebacker coach here. And he's got that back seven playing really good football, making it difficult. And you make a mistake, they make you pay.
You don't want to take the foot off the gas pedal. You think you might just want to run out the half. But so they are doubling up their averages here in the first half offensively. And that time, a little late coming out of his
body language, said, you know what, you're 15 miles away, and I got your number.
He's looking for the bomb again. It's another touchdown to Bug Howard. Are you kidding me?
You're not going to see many quarterbacks in college football play a better half than Marquise did. 404 yards passing, shot after shot after shot down the field. And I love the mindset. I'm going to step on it. I don't against a Duke crew, I will remind you, was number 10 in the country in scoring defense, number 8 in pass defense at 166, and number 9 in total defense at 295. And the Tar Heels shredding this group up. What'd that Stanford DB do with less than 10 seconds to play? If I get beat, tackle the guy. It doesn't matter. I just can't give up that huge explosive going into the locker room.
A defense that, as you said, Brock, does not normally give up big explosive plays, but Duke did. And TJ Logan will take a knee. That means it will be North Carolina.
That deficit.
That's 2 weeks in a row.
They'll start on the ground here with Williams on a run. Dives out to the 30. Act the ball out.
Well,
make a play.
You have to still very much involve Cash, but your perimeter people on the outside have got to play more conservatively.
There's a tackle for loss by A.J. Wolf. Brings up to press the accelerator in the second.
They do, but I think you do want to start eating up that clock.
Williams, a first down pitch and catch with Mac Hollins.
About in half.
Williams again, well protected. Good job, though, with the left hand by Breon Borders.
This group right now is not doing their job with a four-man rush.
This time they go, though, they do their job. Four-man rush. Long throw up against the sideline. Wide open, Mac Hollins.
Clouded it up. He's got to get over the top, and he's not there.
Williams extending the play. Flag down. Lost the football. It comes out sideways. That's exactly what Marquise Williams believes.
Personal foul. Face mask on the defense. 15-yard penalty from the previous
slide. Tiger right now that I have not seen. This is the best game on tape he has ever played.
It just gets easier and easier for North Carolina. A touchdown run for Elijah Hood. And Duke has been demoralized defensively.
Last week was tough. Last week you win a game if you're Duke. That's your game. It's a blown call. You can get over that. When you come out and you face an opponent that's punching you right in the mouth and then throw an uppercut after uppercut after uppercut, 45 points, all your messaging at halftime is get a stop. Get a stop. Do your job. Play each play. And then they come out and much more than I think even a week ago will.
On the defense, penalty is declined. The extra point is good.
Hey. One of the most balanced teams offensively in college football.
That goes out of bounds, so a mistake on the kick by Nick Weiler.
That doesn't help anybody.
Well, let's see how angry they play now, because now it's a character test for Duke, and the character being tested, Jalay Duncan, quickly on second down and close to 11. Four-man rush, pops one over the middle.
It's got to be precise, and Cirk wasn't good enough in the first 30 minutes.
Cirk on a keeper. Nothing doing. Junior Nankande brings him down behind the line. And after giving up another touchdown drive, Duke on the verge of a three and out unless they go for it.
Can't play better than that. I mean, that's absolutely just a physical skill set.
To the U.S. Fourth down and two, and Duke will go for it. Why not? And they'll pick it up. Oh, getting a shot to the back.
See his body, and that was a must for Duke.
Cirk up the middle. There he goes. Thomas Cirk, the quarterback, splits the UNC defense, takes it the distance for a touchdown. 53-yard run.
Well, that's two occasions. Then the Tar Heels are built to limit the damage and limit the big play. And that's two occasions where safety Donnie Miles is that last line of defense. And that's a pretty poor angle, unfortunately, for the redshirt sophomore and the leading tackler. And I said that Cirk had to have over 100-yard day on the ground. It was imperative with what Carolina was going to do defensively that he made them pay with his legs. And really, for the first time this afternoon, he does.
There are only five Power 5 quarterbacks that lead their team in passing and rushing. Cirk, the last 25 years, and now a little pooch kickoff in a no-man's land. Nice sliding catch. made it about the 33-yard line.
That would have been unheard of a decade ago.
Play action for Marquise Williams, up the seam, in stride, Matt Collins, another big play.
And his mindset is, of course they're going to run the ball. Oh, no, they're not. They're going to still throw it.
Now they run it almost as effectively. Six more yards.
Offensive football.
Little screen out to the edge. That's a gain of a couple. Well, Jim Knoll.
This game is reflective of, but whatever it is, it's been dominant.
Williams stumbles, still turns the corner, and it looks like he's got the first down. About 3 yards up the middle for Elijah Hood.
So a good 10 to 15 pound advantage every time for the running back Hood.
Screen tipped as Ryan Switzer had to reach up.
70 and only going up a game.
Williams looking end zone again. Bobbled, caught, Carolina touchdown. Quinshon Davis gets into the end. The 23rd touchdown catch of Quinshon Davis's career.
Matt Collins is the speed, Ryan Switzer is the quickness, and Quinshon Davis is just the pro. The guy that, like Marquise Williams, has been here and he's done it. He owns every record in the receiving crew, and he knows how to use his big body and his frame. It's inside of borders, and no slowing down from this UNC offense.
There are teams of the Big 12 envious of whatever, but LSU, Alabama, would you call that an elimination game, or would the loser of that game still be breathing? Obviously, Alabama, having already lost to Ole Miss, probably in their chance to come back, as Devon Edwards, pretty good return. Out across the 30 to the 31-yard line. Out on the Palouse, as Hogan put on a display with his legs. Sirk with a slam. That's caught, fighting his way for a first down. This Saturday night at Washington
Balance.
State.
Yep.
Sirk knocked away.
And who feels good about themselves here down the stretch of a season?
Quarterback draw, Sirk with a flag down. A couple of flags down in the offensive backfield.
And that's going to be a tackle on the Duke offensive line.
Holding number 79. 10-yard penalty, second down.
Return kick last week. I can't quite do that. But at the same token, if this team was 7-1 and rolling in here.
Tip ball, intercepted. Des Lawrence down the sideline, out of bounds at the 20-yard line. And the embarrassment for Duke continues, and the dominance for North Carolina continues.
Got to be accurate. When you're playing against a group like this that loves to play those two safeties deep and loves to play some of their matchup man concepts underneath, you can't overthrow. See issues which have been really compounded by this defense today.
Hood for about a yard. Well, left
dominated that game 45-20. He knew that they'd have to be much sharper than this.
To the goal line once again, it's Elijah Hood, and once again it's a North Carolina touchdown.
This was a 7-point game, according to a lot of the experts. Our FBI folks thought they're going to be a lot closer than 59-17. I don't think anybody thought Carolina had this kind of precision in their passing game. I think a lot of folks knew they could run it. If you watch the tape, Hood's been running through arm tackles all season long. Looks pretty obvious he falls into the end zone. We're taking a second look at it.
Why? It's across the line.
In the right spots offensively. Larry Fedora's got this thing. It's our fifth-year guys that have been through some of the rough spots in loving this moment of success.
Division is North Carolina.
Overall receiving crew of the Seminoles or this receiving crew?
I would take this receiving crew.
Northwestern still leads.
No matter who's starting at quarterback for Florida State, I guess really Dalvin Cook, if he's healthy, is
yes.
And that ball is dropped by T.J.
Much better than last season.
Four-man rush on third down and two. A check down to Powell. He has the first down across the 50-yard line.
This kid's fundamentally so much better. No freebies, no gimmies. I love their coverage techniques. Right, they don't just blimber.
From 120th to 10th in FBS in yards per completion defensively.
And same personnel.
False right. Start, number 78, five-yard penalty, second down.
If there was an 8 per game. They have totally flipped the script. And that one sails out of bounds. Here comes a blitz. Cirk throws it behind John L. Barnes, but he's able to turn.
Body control when you look for a receiver. To be able to twist his body, make that play with his hands.
Up the middle goes Powell. New process.
That doesn't happen.
He wiped the slate clean. Cirk taking a shot for McCaffrey in the end zone. Great. Another third down for Duke. And close to a first down, slipping free is Rammer. Making moves to the 4-yard line before he's brought down. Quarterback keeper. To the goal line is Cirk. Second effort is good for a touchdown. Another touchdown run for Thomas Cirk. Donnie Miles didn't wrap up, and Cirk kept driving for the goal line.
Tough afternoon and some stretches here for Donnie Miles, and he's going to have a...
...to North Carolina. We haven't even gotten to the fourth quarter yet.
These 16 minutes and 40 seconds may not matter in the overall score. Winding the clock in that play clock, as they've done a bunch of that here in the second half.
Line drive kick through the end zone today on...
...experience. You got to be at your best when it matters the most to your program here in November.
I wonder if maybe down on the sideline, Larry Fedora heard what we were talking about, because that's a true first down. Keep it on the ground with Williams again. And that'll move the sticks.
And I think probably just further infuse those guys with more confidence and belief.
Quick strike right up the seam.
Percent completion, you know what you're doing in the system.
Little toss to the outside. Again, it's Tyson Williams. Inside the 40-yard, and his backup, Nick Trubisky, work on second down and six. Swing pass to Austin Prohl. That's Ricky's son. Has put up 669 yards on Duke today. And 11 different Carolina players have caught a pass. That's the second catch. Getting bottled up this time is Williams. As Devon Edwards makes. Well, Chris, there have been passes completed for 9 yards. And this time they work the play clock to perfection. And toss a little wide receiver screen to Dalton Stock.
There's no foul downfield. However, there was personal foul, roughing the passer, number 16, hitting the quarterback at the knee area. Penalty is half the distance. Automatic first down.
You can see the reaction there from Cash. 15 and a half tackles for loss. Been such an impactful player coming into this game in college football.
And make it first and goal. And off to the freshman, Tyson Williams. The pile moves down to about the 3. Once again, it's the freshman. And once again, he is stopped short of the goal line. There goes Prohl in motion. A keeper for Trubisky. Touchdown.
Well, same play we saw earlier. The first touchdown run that Marquise Williams had. And we highlighted the big right guard, Landon Turner, just blowing up the outside force support. Maybe not quite the same kind of collision from Brad Henson, but the same kind of effect there. As Carolina just cannot be stopped or slowed, whether it's Williams, whether it's Trubisky, whether it's guys that are on the flip card, not even on the depth chart. Just a dominant afternoon for the guys in baby blue.
a good mascot. So they bought one for $25. And then after rubbing the Rams' head. And now Parker Bayman at quarterback for Thomas Cerf. He'll run a little quarterback draw and get about 8 yards back against Northwestern. It's an interesting day on the U in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, Barkley was a guy we didn't.
The 5 team gets into the college football playoff. And maybe is it a situation, if you're
meant, the schedule of their opponent will just not be what a one-loss ACC team or an SEC team or something of that nature. It just won't.
Those elimination games as the Big 12 season moves on. You got one arguably in Stillwater.
Well, and here is what Memphis has that a Boise State had.
Ole Miss does do the improbable, run the table, and win the SEC. Power football played here to Shaq Powell. And he is close to a Duke first season, like Memphis has so far this year, that the argument at least can be made. Bame wrapped up and thrown back.
As a blemish, but same point. You know, just playoff football here starting when that old adage that every week matters in college football, this weekend is a perfect illustration of it.
Dropped by Quay Chambers.
Center David Cutcliffe, but it sure was this afternoon. They had no answer.
Aim on fourth down over the middle, and that is a first down catch.
For the Twitch football, and to get battered and ran the way they did today, humbling.
How about that run by Jalay Duncan? Breaking tackles inside the 10 to the 9 yards. First and goal at the 9. Duncan, no gain with a late up settling in Lakeland, Georgia. He didn't even speak English. Took up American football. Here he is playing for North Carolina. And this looks like it might be a Duke touchdown. And it is. Eric Schneider is able to reach the ball out, hit the pylon with 3:56 to go.
Same kind of action we saw earlier today on a play that MJ Stewart knocked down in the red zone. Some of the inexperienced guys getting to run the number one plays, and that's how Duke executes it, a little higher level. And Schneider with his third touchdown of the season.
Coming, and it will go deep and end up staying in the field of play. That's a live ball, and it gets covered up all the way down to the 7. The backup quarterback Mitch Trubisky got a touchdown run on the last possession for UNC with a toss to the true freshman Tyson Williams.
Won 7 games in a row since the ACC began in 53, just 5 times, and they run that streak to 8 today. And also pretty cool, athletically, physically, North Carolina was the much better team, and it's reflected in the score.
Very close to a first down for Tyson Williams.
And that's what Gene and his defensive staff is doing.
So it will be a punt and a wobbly one at that. But it takes a great Carolina roll all the way down to the 36-yard line with 1-2. When they get an opportunity, lean on the friends that they trust and colleagues that they know are good coaches. And for Gene Chizik to just wipe the slate clean and bring in
tremendous defenses with Bo Pelini and Lincoln. And I think both of those men knowing, hey, I can kind of pick my spot here where I want to do this. Where do I want to go coach? Where can I turn a program? Time his defense is on the field. He's chomping his gum, and he knows, man. He said it. If he could go back and do anything different at Auburn, he'd want to coordinate that defense because he's one of the real good.
Chapel Hill. Pierre bounces it outside. Well, the crowd with one more chance to celebrate. For the 23rd time in the last 26 years, they ring the victory bell for a North Carolina win. A dominant performance. 704 yards of total offense for UNC, and they walk away with a 66-31 win over Duke. For Brock Ewart and Shannon Spake, I'm Bob Wischusen. Let's send it back to College Football Scoreboard.